So the whole purpose of the HX50 landing light suite is to give the pilot the greatest possible situational awareness. Now, we're happy with both the long range and the near range lighting spread that we get from the cluster as it's optically designed at the moment. One of the areas that we've been developing with the wingtip light is ensuring that from the forward focus and around all the way to the sort of 3 o'clock and 9 o'clock positions, we give excellent illumination of the surrounding area to give the pilot the best possible situational awareness, both in congested airport arenas and also when going into unlit off airport sites. The latest generation of the wingtip light has now been tested on the ground using the HX50 ground lighting test rig and gives absolutely exceptional performance. So we're really excited about that. We're just updating the lighting cluster design now to implement that array of optics and LEDs, and then we'll be ready to test those again in conjunction with both the updated signature light and also the night light to finally sign off the whole landing light system optically for flight tests and then certification testing. The signature light down the side of HX50 is an integral part of the overall aircraft experience. It has two functions. Firstly, to form an integral part of the handshake that the aircraft gives to both the pilot and people observing the aircraft when it's in use, but also to provide an integral part of the area lighting provided by the wingtip light for operations in confined areas. We've just finished a concept prototype of the new implementation of the landing light with the diffuser, some improved LEDs, and importantly, some intelligent electronics that allows us to essentially control the LEDs in two manners. Firstly, using the intelligent controls that give us the ability to animate them for the soft touch functions, but then also a hard override that locks them either on or off, which makes certifying them for use on the aircraft much simpler and easier. We've also modified the design of the installation of these lights so that the whole strip cartridge can be removed like removing an oil dipstick out of the end of the door, making service and exchange of these, if ever you had a failure of an LED in there, simple and inexpensive. Let's talk about the nav lights. So the compliant nav lights that are part of the wingtip cluster lights, those are already at a performance level we're satisfied with. We just need to slightly tweak the mechanical shuttering of those to prevent bleed past the 110 degrees aft. So that's been included into the latest generation of both the port and starboard lights, and then those two will be optically signed off and ready for official testing. So the focus then with all of these clusters becomes the design for manufacture and endurance testing for vibration, thermals, and the various other aspects of the design. In terms of the final lamp cluster, the tail light, the strobe performance we've tested on the ground and is outstanding. It's far in excess of what's provided on contemporary aircraft. And the navigation light is again fully compliant with the requirements of the certification standards and TSOs. So those things are essentially ready for productionization and then final approval testing. So with the whole lighting suite in general, we're about 2 or 3 weeks away from being able to sign these things off from an engineering point of view as compliant with our performance specifications. They do everything that we wanted them to and more. Super pleased with the lights.